नमस्कार। आप सभी लोग अपने अपने घरों पर सकुशल होंगे तथा COVID-19 से बच रहे होंगे। और इस जून के महीने में जो गर्मी बहुत बढ़ गई है, तो साथ ही गर्मी से बचने का उपाय भी कर रहे होंगे। तब लिक्विड का बहुत सेवन कर रहे होंगे, ऐसी आशा है। तो ऐसा वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दी एनाटोमी ऑफ द फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स इन विच वी हैव टॉक अबाउट सो मैनी थिंग्स अबाउट द टिश्यूज। लेट्स मूव दैट अनदर टॉपिक, दैट इज वी कैन से द एनाटोमी ऑफ डाइकोटिलेडोन एंड द मोनोकोटिलेडोन प्लांट्स इन विच वी हैव टू टूडे वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट द एनाटोमी ऑफ द लीफ ऑफ द डाइकॉट एंड द मोनोकॉट। एज वी यू ऑल नोन अबाउट द मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ द लीफ, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द मॉर्फोलॉजिकल स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ द लीफ in previous one, as you can see in the diagram over here. With the help of morphology you can easily understand about the leaves one. Next we can talk about the leaves, in which you all must know that if we talk about the leaf of the dicotyledons, that is dorsoventrally leaf, they are found over there. And the dorsoventral leaves are generally horizontal and sunlight falls on their upper surfaces, right? Means we can say that is the word adaxial surfaces, right? Means the upper surface or the ventral surface or the adaxial surface, maybe anywhere else. But we can say the vertical section of the dorsal leaf through the lamina shows the different parts. Even if we talk about there, that these leaf lamina head shows the different tissues in there, that is epidermis, mesophylls and the vascular system in them. So we have to, today we have to talk especially about this dicotyledons leaf one, right? So we have to start it that if we talk about the epidermis, right, means as you can see in the diagrams, especially over there, this is the adaxial parts of epidermis and this is the abaxial. Mean the topmost, the upper part of that is called adaxial, and the lower one that is called the abaxial. So we have to start it about that the upper epidermis, it is the uppermost part of a single layer made up of the parenchymatous cells, and sometimes it is also a multi-layer one in some plants like the pepper, ficus, nerium, and begonia. So on plant, it is generally found over there. And we can say there is a cuticle which can be always covers on this epidermis, right? Or if we talk about the outgrowth, that is called the papillae or the gladiolus. And generally you are not seeing over there, but some plants have the outgrowths over their surfaces, that is gladiolus, especially which you have seen. They can be present sometimes on the outer or upper epidermis, and the stomata are the usually less present in the upper surfaces, right? And they are mostly found in the lower surfaces. Or we can say the chloroplasts are not present in the this layer, especially in the upper epidermis layer, the chloroplast is not present over there, right? So if we talk about the lower epidermis, right, means that is the lower epidermis, it may be we can say the stomata and the chloroplast are more in numbers in the lower epidermis surfaces, and we can say there is a substomatal cavity is present in the below the stomata for the exchanges of the gases one. Then we have to talk the second layer, that is the mesophyll. Especially in previously we all have known that it is differentiated into two parts, dorsoventral leaves, it may be upper parasite or the lower spongy parenchyma, right? So the parasite cells contains the evident chloroplast, hence they are major seats of the photosynthetic activity, right? Evenly, the spongy parenchyma lies below the parasite parenchyma and above the lower epidermis. This spongy parenchyma cells contain several chloroplasts, but less than the number of present in the parasites cells over there for the doing their conditions. So we can say they are adaxially placed, elongated in cells, So such structures are found over there. If we talk about the mesophyll parenchyma, oval, they are the oval shape, round shape, loosely arranged, and parasite cells or air cavities are present over there. Then we have to talk about the next one, that is the vascular systems in the leaf. Especially if we can talk about the vascular systems in the leaf, the vascular bundles are conjoined, right? Collateral, endarch, and closed. Previously we have talked about this conjoined, what are the different conjoined type of the vascular bundles, collateral type of vascular bundles over there. So I think everybody remembers about that one. If you not remember, you, I am just giving you a shortcuts of those types of vascular bundles in that particular condition. If we talk about the conjoined type of, in which I have told you, the xylem and phloem are always present together in the same bundles, in the same radii, right? So they are known as conjoined type of vascular bundles. Even if we talk about a collateral, in which the xylem and phloem lie together on the same radius, that is from the what? That is called the collateral type of vascular bundles. And if we talk about the another thing, right, means these are endarch or exarch. Endarch means generally they are formed in the inside one, right? If you remember, I have just told you about this and xylem and phloem structures. When we have talked about their these vascular bundles, especially in previous one, well, you have known about this, that the what are the exarchs and what are the endarchs. As I told you, that when the protoxylem lies toward the center of pith and metaxylem lies toward the peripheral, in that conditions the vascular bundles are known as the endarch. And opposite of this means when the protoxylem is toward the periphery and the metaxylem towards the center, in that conditions they are the exarch. So this way they can be found over there, and they are generally closed. And if we talk about the bundles, vascular bundles, they are surrounded by the bundle set of the parenchyma cells, and the xylem present towards the upper epidermis also, right? So these can be shown with the help of different structures, as you can see in the diagram one. Evenly we can say the xylem is present towards the upper epidermis, that is adaxial, as the topper one places, right? And suppose the xylem is present over in this here, in this region, they are the, we can say they are the adaxial. When they are found over in such regions, they are become the abaxial surfaces. And we can say the xylem consists several tracheids, trachea, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fibers. It can be, we can say, for the conduction of the minerals, for the conduction of the water in the plant one, right? So The phloem is made up of the sieve tube, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fibers. These vascular bundles are surrounded by the layer of thick walled cells. They can be commonly known as bundle of Seth cells, right? Especially if we talk about the plant, especially C4 plant, right? There you will understand about this one, such type of things in that particular condition. Evenly, if we then talk about the vascular bundles, can be seen in veins and midrib. The size of vascular bundles varies along to the size of the veins also, right? And we can say the veins vary thickness in the reticulate venations. And if we talk about the midrib, right, the mesophylls is absent in the region of the midrib, and other larger veins and parenchyma, sclerenchyma, and occurs toward the epidermal layers to provide the mechanical strength of the center. Center contains a number of vascular bundles which are embedded in the parenchymatous tissue, especially in the leaf. If we can directly talk about the different features for identification of the dicot leaves, right? Simply we can just, generally the dicot leaves are dorsiventrally flattened with the stomata mostly on the upper surfaces. Mesophylls differentiated into the palisade and spongy parenchyma. Vascular bundles with the colorless bundles, they are generally found into the C4 plants. and the vascular bundles with the xylem towards upper side and the towards the lower side. Means the vascular bundles with xylem towards upper as well as on the lower upper side and the phloem towards the lower side. Means as you can see, especially in the diagram, these vascular bundles, especially xylem, is found on the upper surfaces and the phloem is found the lower surface over here. Means they can be follows like such structures. Means you can just see the here the xylem one, and just below that there is a phloem structure are found over there in the dicot leaf. Let's move to talk our next, that is monocotyledonous leaf. Generally, the monocotyledonous leaf is isobilateral structure, right? And we can say that, but sometimes they can be changed, like in some plants like the Musa and the Canna. There are examples of dorsoventral leaf, just like the dicot leaves are found over there. But we can say the leaves usually shows parallel variations and veins running parallel to each other. And this, the leaf of monocot have also different main parts. If we talk about the epidermis, mesophylls and vascular system, right? So first of all, we have to talk about the epidermis. Means generally, this epidermis is structures of this leaf. Right. So again, these leaves can be composed of the upper surface and upper and lower, both epidermis made up of the single layer of compact arranging cells. And we can say the upper layer covering with the cuticle. Cuticle means, as I have already told you, the waxy layer which makes the leaves the water resistance. Right. Evenly, we can say in some grasses the epidermal cells are impregnated with silica, and the stomata are generally found in both upper and lower surfaces of the epidermis. Right? At the some places, epidermis possesses a large size of thin walled, colorless, protruding cells called bulliform cells or the motor cells. We can say that these become placid when water is not sufficient. Generally, the bulliform cells are pichak jati hai. ठीक जब प्लांट को वाटर प्रॉपर नहीं मिल पाता है, बट व्हेन द लीव्स अगेन बिकम फ्लैट, राइट, दे कैन चेंज देयर प्लेसेस व्हेन वाटर इज अवेलेबल एंड वल्लीफॉर्म सेल्स बिकम टर्गिड, राइट, द वल्लीफॉर्म सेल्स मे बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इररेगुलर अरेंजमेंट इनटू द रेगुलर पैटर्न ऑफ द लीव्स वन. ओनली वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज मेसोफिल सेल्स. अगेन दिस मेसोफिल सेल्स are made up of chlorogametous ground tissues of leaves. It can undifferentiated, mean not differentiated between the palisade and the spongy parenchymatous tissues. So in the, especially in monocot leaves, all we can say, all the cells are similar, as the intercellular spaces are connected, the two with substomatal cavities, and the stoma mesophyll cells contain the evident chloroplast. Hence, they can also a site of the or a seat of the photosynthesis, especially in the monocotyledonous leaf. We can talk about the vascular bundles, right? As you can just see in the vascular bundles, means generally the xylem and phloem over there. So the large number of vascular bundles is present. Some of them are small and some are big. So each vascular bundle is surrounded by a bundle of sac of the parenchymatous tissue cells, right? And we can see above and the below the larger bundle, the patches of the sclerenchymatous cells are present over there, right, students? So if we talk about the details of these vascular bundles, they are again conjoint, collateral, enlarged and closed, as in the same to same into the dicotyledons. I have already told you. Conjoint means the arrangement of the protoxylem and metaxylem. Collateral, the whenever they are attached to each other. Enlarged means generally where their structure are formed at the upper, in the inside, towards the pith or towards the peripheral regions. So on the basis they can be classified. In some grasses we can say these Vascular bundles are surrounded by a distinct parenchymatous bundle set, and the xylem is present towards the upper epidermis and foramen towards the lower epidermis. So we can say the xylem and foramen elements of the monocot leaves are similar to those of the dicot leaf. After that, we have to talk about the midrib. Generally, if you have seen the leaf structures, right, of these, especially these leaf structures or midrib, generally the widest part of the monocot leaf, a shallow groove is present in the upper adaxial. Agar aapne गन्ने की पत्ती या फिर मेज़ की मक्के की पत्ती देखी होगी तो उसमें सेंटर पार्ट पे अपर सरफेस पे एक हल्का सा ग्रूव इस टाइप देगा, हल्की सी नाली ऐसा स्ट्रक्चर दिखाई देता है, राइट। जस्ट अपोजिट ऑफ दैट देयर इज अनदर वेल द वी कैन से अपोजिट सरफेस वी कैन से द रिजिड इज प्रेजेंट ओवर देयर, राइट, एट द एबेक्सियल सरफेसेस। सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस structure easily over there. If we talk about the features, right, of the identifying features of the monocotyledon leaf, we can say these leaves are undifferentiated mesophylls, means the mesophyll cells are undifferentiated, means they are always distributed differentiately. Or we can say the presence of bundle of sheath with chloroplast, the vascular bundles with xylem towards upper side and phloem towards the lower side of the epidermis, and xylem vessels are rounded. As I have told you, you can see xylem vessels over, especially in this condition, they are the rounded structures, right, and the presence of the few large size bulliform cells on the upper surfaces are found over there in that particular condition. So these can be seen with the help of easily with all connectors, right. Or we can talk about on the their differentiations, right. If we talk about the bundles of, as I told you, right, that in dicot made up of the collenchyma, but in the monocot they are made up of sclerenchyma. Mesophyll cells, they are parasite and spongy in parenchyma, but spongy in parenchyma in monocot cells. Stomata, they are found in upper epidermis, in monocot both places are found over there. And if we talk about the orientations of these leaves, so on the basis of the orientations, the leaves are generally easy to understand that dicot leaves are dorsoventrally and monocot leaves with the isobilateral structures, right. If we can talk about the on the basis of stomata, the dicot leaves are hypostomatic and the monocot leaf are the amphi-isostomatic over there. If we talk about motor cells generally they are found in the monocot leaves on the upper surface, upper epidermis, but it is absent in the lower one. Mesophyll cells, I have told you that especially in the dicot leaf they are the differentiated into the parasite and spongy parenchyma, but they are undifferentiated into the monocot one. Veins, they are irregularly scattered, but in the dicot, but in case of the monocot, they are the parallel arranged in the with the midrib one. If we talk about xylem vessels, generally many protoxylem and the intraxylem vessels are found over there, but toward the into the monocot, two protoxylem and two metaxylem vessels in each bundles are found over there. So this way, this is the structures, the anatomical structures of the dicotyledonous plant and leaf, right, plants leaf we have talked today now. So you must prepare the notes and the diagrams, right, with the labeling also. Then we will talk about the next topic tomorrow about this lesson.